Her next guest is a fintech company that lets its users spend, send, and lend within any app. For more on this and the state of the digital economy in the Philippines and across Asia Pacific, Shailesh Naik of MatchMove joins us live. Shailesh, hi, welcome to Market Edge.
Hi there, thank you for having me.
All right, Shailesh, Singapore is home to over 1,000 fintech companies. And you know, when I Googled, MatchMove is in the top 10 list of the most well-funded fintechs. The list I looked at has you at $151 million. Is it close?
Very close, yes.
Okay.
But still not enough.
All right. Shailesh, out of 1,000 fintechs there, and I imagine dozens other players in the countries where you operate, India, Indonesia, Vietnam, Hong Kong, Malaysia, Philippines, what makes MatchMove different? What makes you stand out?
So first of all, fintech is addressing a fundamental problem in the existing financial services world. You know, banks are trapped in legacy systems, typically legacy thinking. Meanwhile, the world is digitalizing. Every organization, big and small, public and private, is digitalizing. They need better solutions. And unfortunately, most banks, not all, but most banks can't keep up with it. That's where fintechs come in. Now, within that space, what MatchMove does is we solve for the problem of speed and security. Any organization could be, for example, we work with food delivery companies, we work with shipping companies, we work with crypto exchanges. All of them need a better, faster way of moving money safely, securely. That's what MatchMove provides. So sometimes we call it an embedded finance company or a banking as a service, and it's one of the fastest growing areas within fintech. What we've also done recently is acquired a very well-known e-commerce infrastructure company called Shopmatic.
Yes.
Now, what that does for us is it enables a one-stop digitalization shop. You want to digitalize, no matter what your strategy, insurance, public sector, governments, you need to first get your SMEs, you need to get your individual sellers, sari-sari stores, or even SMEs that are part of a supply chain. They need to be digitalized first, and Shopmatic has one of the best technologies in the world to enable that quickly and securely. Mm-hmm. With that in play, now what happens is the data starts to move, we can actually see the data, and we can provide all kinds of financial services. It could be supply chain lending, it could be vendor flows, it could be factoring. All of it can become digital. Mm-hmm. And this is something that now everyone expects. You know, we're so comfortable on our phone, we spend so much time doing things on our phone that are actually really fundamental to the way we live. Why not have that with money? Why not have that with the way you run your business? And that's what we provide.
Shailesh, how big are you in the Philippines today? I mean, give us the numbers. How big is your market share? How big is your network? How many customers or partners or merchants or clients do you have?
So we're a B2B company, so we count the number of brands or markets that we work with. As far as market share is concerned, because we are a new age player, there's no real evidence out there of anyone measuring market share. What I can tell you is that the Philippines is one of our key markets in Southeast Asia, along with Indonesia. Philippines for us is growing about probably 100-150% year on year. Mm-hmm. Our go-to market involves partnering with local financial services providers to meet regulatory requirements from the BSP. And so today we partner with AUB, Asia United Bank.
Oh, okay.
And one example of how people in the Philippines are actually benefiting from that includes Hello Money, which is a digital banking product powered by MatchMove at the back. And the other is the Atomi card, which was recently released. Again, buy now, pay later. Why do they come to us? Because we take care of the complexity. There's a lot of complexity, moving money, data, security, anti-money laundering, all kinds of stuff that needs to be addressed. Mm-hmm. We take care of that so they can create the right user experience for their users.
Because Shailesh, for many fintechs that just entered or are about to enter, there's a notion, and correct me if I'm wrong, there's a notion, there seems to be a perception that you guys are simply chipping away at the lion's share held by telco giants who set up their e-wallets here first. What do you say to that?
So, I mean, first of all, kudos to the telcos in the Philippines. If we look back at telcos around the world, they have been making, you know, always unsuccessful attempts typically to enter the financial services space. Telcos are suffering from loss of SMS revenue, you know, voice, everything's WhatsApp, it's free. So for them, a natural evolution would be into financial services. And you can look at every telco in just about every part of the world, they've all attempted it and typically all have failed. The only place in the world where telcos have successfully done this, in my opinion, is in the Philippines. Now, what have they done so well? You know, we talk about GCash and others. They took very good advantage of their penetration, mobile penetration, the rapid increase of payment options. Also, the fact that typically local banks were not ready yet. And, you know, telcos are typically tech-led, so they have the ability to create tech products. Mm-hmm. And they massively swept through through the Philippines. Philippines itself being not one geographical mass, but, you know, separated, and therefore reach, mobile ability, access to data. That's something they've done very, very well, and they've leveraged on it. Now, coming to your point about fintechs chipping away, well, the fintech world actually addresses financial services. And financial services, if you think of what banks offer today and what we call at MatchMove, spend, send, lend, defend, ascend. Mm-hmm. We provide the ability to spend a card, QR codes or whatever. Send means remit locally, domestically or cross border. Lend means borrow, either directly or from we match you to a borrower. Defend means insurance, so that you can buy insurance. And finally, ascend means you can invest. So what the telcos have done today is brilliantly established a very strong market share in that first bit. But there are many other services which new age tech startups or even governments who want to mm-hmm. leapfrog need the other range of services. And that's why Anatomy, for example, came to us. That's why our customers come to us, because yes, the telcos do have a very strong offering, very convenient for consumers and even, you know, small businesses in the Philippines. But as you mature, you're going to need to add more and more services, mm-hmm. and that's where we come in.
All right, looks like the ocean is still blue. Thank you very much, Shailesh, for joining us this morning, and good luck for your ventures here in the Philippines.